Welcome to Maxability. To unfold different layers of knowledge, stay tuned with us till the end of the video.
Hello everyone, welcome to Maxability. This is lesson 7 of the series Using Mac with VoiceOver. In this lesson, let us see how to use web on Mac using VoiceOver. I'll be demonstrating using web with the Safari browser. Safari and VoiceOver on Mac all are Apple products and have a greater support. The first thing I have to do is to open Safari. So I have already opened, but if you haven't, use the spotlight command spacebar and type in Safari to open the Safari browser. Once the browser is opened, you need to go to the address bar to type in the address. So the shortcut command to do that is command L, L for location. Command L, let me do that.
Open location,
It says open location and is reading the current address already there, HTTP something. So let me delete that. Command A.
Select all.
Select all. Delete.
Selection deleted.
Deleted. Now let me type in the address.
Maxability web content.
I have typed in the entire address, but in certain cases, as you start typing in, it populates the possible options if you have already used that web page. So I have typed in the full address and the web page is now loaded. Once the page is loaded, it may say certain percentages and stop it. That is when you can understand that the page is loaded. The first thing usually the screen reader users do to ensure that they are in the right page is using the title or the reading the title of the page. How do I do that? In NVDA or JAWS on Windows, we usually do that with insert plus T, T for title. NVDA key or JAWS key plus T for the title. With VoiceOver, I have a shortcut command to read the document title. So I can do VO command plus shift plus I.
Home, Maxability, page has 45 links, 16 headings, 6 form controls, 4 landmarks, 1 image.
So it says there is 1 image, a number of headings, list links and all that summary along with the title of the page. It said home, Maxability. Let me do that again.
Home, Maxability, page has
home, Maxability. So that is the title of the page and I'm sure that I'm on the right page now. So now there are two ways of navigating the web page. One is using the tab key from one control to another. Using tab and shift tab will navigate only to the interactive controls like the links, buttons, form elements, etc. The second one is to use the general navigation method with VoiceOver, that is VO plus right arrow to the next control and VO plus left arrow to the previous control. Let me start with using the tab key. Pressing the tab.
Link, skip to content.
Link, skip to the content. That's the first interactive control.
Visited, link, image, Maxability logo, banner.
So it's on the banner landmark.
Towards an inclusive web.
With the visited link, image, and it says Maxability. And there is a title to this link, so it is also saying towards an inclusive web. That's an additional information. In most cases, it will not be part of the link.
Search, search text field, blank. Submit, button. Link, like us on Facebook. Link, follow us on Twitter. Link, follow us on LinkedIn. Link, Contact us through email. Link. Watch us on YouTube. Visited. Link. Home. List 7 items.
So when I'm navigating through the tab, it is one, reading the link, the type of the control, whether it is a link or a button or a text box. It is reading the label or accessible name of that control. And it is also saying the container. In the previous case, it said banner. And in this case, it is saying list of 7 items. So starting with home, there should be 7 items. Second one.
Link. About.
About.
Link. Trainings.
3.
Link. Community.
4.
Link. Blog.
5.
Link. Contact US.
6.
Link. Login/register.
7. So that's the last item. So I should be out of the list now.
Visited. Link. CSS content property.
So it didn't announce the end of list, but it went directly to the next interactive control. Though there are certain controls on the page, so there is certain text on the page which is non-interactive. So the simple logic here is using tab, and let me do a shift tab to go back.
Link, login/register, list 7 items.
With the shift tab and the tab keys, you will not be able to navigate through the non-interactive controls or non-interactive elements on the page. So let me now go to the top of the page and start doing the second type of navigation.
Link, conf, link, blog, link, community, link, trainings, link, about, visited, link, home, link, watch us on YouTube, link, contact us through email, link, follow us on LinkedIn, link, follow us on Twitter, link, like us on Facebook, submit, button, search, search text field, blank, visited, link, image, maxability logo, then link, skip to content.
So I am on the first control on the page. Now let me do the next type of navigation, that is using VO keys plus right arrow. Let me lock the VO keys first. Control option, semicolon.
Control option lock on.
Control option lock is now turned on. I can press right arrow to move to the next control and left arrow to go to the previous control.
Banner. Visited, link, image, maxability logo. Towards an inclusive web. End of banner. Search, search text field, blank. Submit, button. Link, like us on Facebook. Link, follow us on Twitter. Link, follow us on LinkedIn. Link, contact us through email. Link, watch us on YouTube. Navigation.
So now it says navigation, which means the navigation region is starting.
List 7 items.
The same thing, list with 7 items.
Visited, link, home, 1 of 7.
Here it is also saying the list. When we are doing the tab key, we have counted ourselves. But now in this case, screen reader is also reading the list with total number of items and the current item number.
Link, about, 2 of 7. Link, trainings, 3 of 7. Link, community, 4 of 7. Link, blog, 5 of 7. Link, contact US, 6 of 7. Link, login/register, 7 of 7.
This is the last item in the list. Now pressing right arrow.
End of list.
It said end of list.
End of navigation.
End of navigation also.
Main.
Now the main region of the page is starting from here.
Heading level 1, maxability.
Heading level 1, maxability.
Maxability had been invigorating the world with accessibility awareness for more than a decade. At this moment, Maxability is all set to storm the world of digital medium with their digital accessibility innovations. For a better understanding, we know that the inability to accessibility rises from environment and poor designing and not from the individual's disability, which has led us to digital accessibility innovations.
So it is reading a paragraph of text.
End of main. Heading level 2, web accessible difficulties.
So that is how you navigate from one control to another, one element to another. And when you are using VO plus right arrow or VO plus left arrow, screen reader will navigate to every control irrespective of whether that is an interactive or non-interactive control. Let me go back to the top.
End of main. Maxability had been invigorating the world with accessibility awareness for more than a decade. At this moment, Maxability is all set to storm the world of digital medium with their digital accessibility innovations. For a better understanding, we know that the inability to accessibility rises from environment and poor designing and not from the individual's disability, which has led us to digital accessibility innovations.
So if you feel like this is reading fast, watch our previous video using VoiceOver utility, and you can adjust the speed, pitch, and all other variations of VoiceOver. Lesson 6.
Heading Level 1. Maxability. Main. End of Navigation. End of List. Link. Login/Register. Link. Contact US. Link. Blog. 5. Link. Community. 4 of 7. Link. Trainings. 3 of 7. Link. About. 2 of 7. Visited. Link. Home. 1 of 7. List 7 items. Navigation. Link. Watch us on YouTube. Link. Contact us through email. Link. Follow us on LinkedIn. Link. Follow us on Twitter. Link. Like us on Facebook. Submit. Button. Search. Search text field. End of banner. Visited. Link. Image. Maxability logo. Towards an inclusive web. Banner. Link. Skip to content.
I am on the top of the page now. Let me turn off the VO modifier. Control Option semicolon.
Control Option lock off.
Control Option lock is now turned off.
Link image. Maxability logo image. Link content.
The other thing with Safari is that in certain cases, and most of the times, you can also use up and down arrow, which I may or may not be recommending. But in case if you want, you can also use up and down arrow keys to navigate, similar to what you have done with VoiceOver modifier key plus right and left arrows. So that's how you navigate different controls. How to interact with these controls? Let me
skip to content. Link, link, content.
When you hear skip to content, press
visited, link, image, map, link, skip to content.
Skip to content. Press return key
and 12 more items group,
and your focus is jump directly to the main content region of the page.
Contact group heading level 2. Contact us group educating through online courses.
So that's how you can navigate. I think it went to a different portion of the page. I have to check that. But to interact with the controls like links or buttons, you can press enter key or the return key on the Mac. So that will navigate you to the portion or link or the button, whichever the action that is associated with it. In a different lesson, I will talk how to fill in a form, how to select items, how to fill in the data, and how to use forms with VoiceOver. And in the next lesson, we'll be looking at some of the shortcut commands or quick commands to use Mac with VoiceOver on Safari. Thank you for watching this video.
Thank you for watching and being with us. Please like and share the video. Don't forget to click on the bell icon. And also, for more updates, subscribe the channel.